pushing on. Things are gonna get better. Hey everyone! So my name is Shivy Williams and I am your health, wellness, and fitness accountability coach. And so today, I wanted to come to you because I was asked this question, and I am going to answer this question. And I'm also going to relate it to your fitness journey, right? So the question was, can two people that are of different religions date? Now again, I'm going to have a scripture, I'm going to read that, and I'm going to relate this whole conversation also to your fitness journey. So don't worry, I'm going to circle back around. But let me answer this question first. So I did find a scripture, and it said, it's 2 Corinthians 6:14 that says, do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship has righteousness with lawlessness, and what communion, I can't even read my handwriting, and what communion has light with darkness? I think that's it. Y'all can look it up. So anyway, so let me answer the question first. So according to that scripture, if people are all of different religion backgrounds, they should not date or be married. Now, we'll say this. You will need to be in prayer about that, because I know there are people that get married, they have different religious backgrounds, and it works for them. And some people have the exact same religion background and it does not work for them, right? It does not work for them dating or being married. So you have to really be in prayer about who you commune with, who you decide to date, your religious beliefs, and all those other things. So I would be in prayer about that. You talk to the person, see what they believe. You know, are you guys gonna have children together? Because if you do, then what religion do you raise them? So those are some things to think about. But let me now, so my answer to that is, according to the scripture, you should not. My other answer to that is, you need to be in prayer. You have people of the same faith, right? They have the exact same faith, but they are not, they may not get along, may not even be able to date each other. So you want to be in prayer about that. You guys just make sure that you're on the same page. The other thing is, it's not just about being unequally yoked when it comes just to the religion perspective of that, right? You don't want to be unequally yoked with anyone, right? You guys, when you want to be on the same level and be thinking the same along the same lines. So for example, if you are a go-getter and you're all business-minded, you may want to be with someone that is also business-minded, at least a little bit. You don't want to be with someone that's lazy, they just la la la. You don't want to be unequally yoked that way either. So now let me relate this to our fitness journey. How does that relate to our fitness journey, right? Not being unequally yoked with other people. Well, here's one thing. You know, you want to be with like-minded people when it comes to your fitness journey. So what you want to do is you want to be around other people that are trying to lose weight. They've been where you've been before, so they understand your journey. So you want to make sure that you are not around people who in the fitness journey would be unequally yoked. You don't want to be around people who are downing you. You don't want to be around people who are telling you basically you can't do it, right? So it's okay to have friends that are not working out. It's okay to have friends and family that are not eating healthy, but you wanna limit the amount of people like that that are around you, right? Because you're trying to get to another level and you cannot have people around you that are not trying to help you get that way or to get to that level. So you definitely don't want to be unequally yoked with other people that don't believe what you believe when it comes to your fitness journey. You definitely want to have people there that are encouraging you, motivating you, inspiring you, telling you to keep going. Not those people that don't believe what you believe when it comes to your health. So here's another example. Those of you who are losing weight, you have probably had people come to you and they have said, oh, you know, you're doing such a great job. What are you doing because I see you lose weight? And you tell them, right? You tell them and you say, yeah, well, I'm exercising this many times and I am eating these. I stopped eating this and now I'm eating this instead. And, you know, the journey's not always perfect, but, you know, I'm doing what I can. And so you just tell them kind of your story. And so they say, oh, okay, they're all excited, but they never start, right? And then they keep coming back to you and they never start, right? So those are not necessarily people you want to be yoked with, right? They want to be exactly where they are. They want to stay exactly where they're at. Although they are consistently complaining, they don't want to make a change. You want to be around changers. You want to be around people that are changing, that are encourage you to change, right? So think about that. And think about that in the aspect of your whole entire life, not just your fitness, not just your religion. At work, you want to think about your friends, you know. Are you and your friends equally yoked? You know, so some people, they're equally yoked with their friends. Maybe they like to drink and smoke and party. Guess what? They're all equally yoked, right? They all believe the same thing, which is why they go out and they have a good time and they party. Maybe it is religion. You and your friends and your family, y'all equally yoked that way. Maybe it's you and your spouse, right? Y'all like to do the same things. You enjoy each other's company. So you're equally yoked that way. So you just want to make sure you're around those people that have the same motivation, same encouragement, that you know you guys encourage each other. So you don't want to be around, again, don't want to be around people that are not encouraging you, not motivating you. And those people come from different places and different areas. Like you may meet someone, maybe you're walking and then you all of a sudden meet somebody and they say, hey, let's walk together. Bam. Maybe it's all on social media, right? Maybe you're joining one of my 30-day challenges, or you're joining me for the Facebook Live workout, or you're watching my workouts on YouTube, and that's encouraging you, and that's keeping you going, because that's what keeps me going, right? That's keeping you going. And so then we become equally yoked because we're on the same plane when it comes to fitness, exercising, trying to eat healthy. I want to live a better life, not just for myself, but for my family, right? I want to be around as long as I possibly can. And so do you. So we're all on that journey together. Maybe the people at your job, right? Maybe people that are go-getters. Like maybe you're a go-getter. You need to be around other people that are go-getters and actually doing even better than you are, right? They're striving and doing more, much more than you're doing, right? So they're going to pull you up. So have some pull-up people and not people that pull you down. Okay, you guys. So remember, make sure you are around people that are equally yoked with you, not just in the religious perspective, but in your whole entire life. You want to be around those people that are going to encourage and motivate you and keep you on the same path, right? Because if you get people in your life, they're not equally yoked with you, guess what sometimes happens? They will pull you to their end of the spectrum, and now you become equally yoked over here when really you want to be right here. You want to be here, they're over there, and they will pull you that way to some place you don't even want to go. That's just like people who were alcoholics or drug addicts. Guess what? At one point, they were equally yoked with the same people that do what they do, right? They're drug addicts, they drink, whatever, party. And then when they decide to change, in order to not get pulled back into there, they have to become unequally yoked, and then they have to become yoked with people who are doing or being what they want to be. Right, because if they start hanging out with people that drink and stuff, guess what? They're gonna go back that way. Same with your fitness journey. It's okay. You have friends. Everybody's not on this journey with you, but those that are trying to always discourage you and trying to get you to eat unhealthy and trying to get you not to work out, and you look fine, but you know you got some more work to do, or you're on medication. Sometimes you have to let them people go, and you have to really bond or become equally yoked with those that are more like you, even if it is through social media, and learn how to say no. All right, you guys, so here we go. Make sure you guys join me, right, so we can become equally yoked on this fitness journey. Come and join me either on YouTube at LBX Fitness and do the workouts, or on my Facebook page where I do Facebook Live workouts, and they are less than 30 minutes, right? We do them Monday through Friday. Those are free, so come and join. You do them from the comfort of your own house. There are modified versions for everyone. There are exercises for everyone to do. You just do your best. You give 100%. You don't have to do what I'm doing, right? Maybe you can only do 5 of whatever I'm doing, and I'm doing 20. That's perfectly okay. You just do what you're doing. Let's get yoked. Let's not get tongue-tied. Let's get equally yoked together, and let's make it happen on our fitness journey. All right, you guys, have an awesome night, and I will see you guys in our next workout. Bye.
emotional.